Hello, I thought I'd do something different again today to return to an alternative format. We're going to do another book review, but shortly it's not going to be the longest thing you ever see. Just a quick overview of something that I read recently. And that book is Scholastic Philosophy. It's an introduction by Marief de Wolf. I'll read you some of the background to it, some of the information, and then give you some of my thoughts about it. It's a really old book. De Wolf was an academic in Belgium in around the turn of the 1900s. He worked mainly around scholastic philosophy and medieval philosophy. He was at the Catholic Institute of Louvain, I think, which was set up by one of Pope Leo the, I can't remember which. It's really an attempt to synthesize a basic introduction to scholastic philosophy. It's not too thick, as you can see. It's quite dense, however, though. I mean, this is quite a. For calling it an introductory text, it's quite funny because it's quite heavy if you don't have any background to other knowledge about philosophy or the ability to read things like Latin. It can be a bit of a challenge. I wouldn't say this is a book for a neophyte. It can be a bit challenging, although I did enjoy it thoroughly. So, what is the book about? Well, it's an attempt to demystify what scholastic philosophy is, really. It's quite funny. You might think it is an easy question to answer. What is scholastic philosophy? And it takes about the first 90 pages to go over it, to give it a definition, trying to explain that you can't explain it by a recourse to theology. You can't have it as a recourse to its main adherents and people who popularized it, such as Thomas Aquinas, etc., etc. And it's really quite hard to understand. He also talks about the scholastic method of teaching, and there's a whole section about the neo-scholasticism, the ideas of how it was trying to be reinvented and rejuvenated around that time, around the beginning of the 1900s, particularly in France and Europe. He talks about his connection to the Catholic Church and theology, as I've mentioned. It will give you quite a good introduction to the subject as a whole, but it's not definitive. There is quite a lot of myth-busting as well in it. Else did he do? He tried to revoke people's ideas about who defined it as a kind of dry interpretation of Catholic dogma applied to philosophy as well. It's a defense as well as an introduction, I'd say. To contra people's incorrect understandings of it. What can you say from that, really? There is an ending bit where he talks about the end of the book talks about the actual Louvain school itself, its formation and how it was set up. It's a little bit interesting if you're interested in a bit of history. I would say if you've got an interest in scholasticism, medieval history, or all the structures of medieval universities, it might be of interest to you. That's about it. It's heavy going, but it's worth trying. You'll learn something just by reading through it. So there you go. Scholastic Philosophy, Maurice de Wolf. If nothing else, you'll get to learn the ins and outs of what scholastic philosophy constitutes, how it goes through theodicy, its attitude to psychology, moral philosophy, logic, etc., etc. He breaks it down quite well. You have an idea of the categories that go into it and what forms it, and the general overview of how the subject is divided. That's about it, really. He does some other wonderful books about medieval philosophy you might want to check out, but. Yeah, I would say overall, hard going but worth it because you learn a lot just through the process of reading it. That's it. Have a dig.